Hello YouTube and welcome to the first video in a new freight series of videos I'm going to be making for Train Simulator. I'm going to just be making a few of these videos alongside the route learning series. The biggest difference is that because we're driving freight and most freight trains are limited in speed to a speed below the actual line speed, I'm not doing this as a route learning video, just more as a cab ride and just to help you see what the experience of driving freight is like in the UK. In this video we're going to be driving a class 33 on train 6 Charlie 83, the 1640 grain to Shakespeare Cliff freight train, which is hauling a rake of unfitted sea urchin wagons. We're actually hauling concrete segments for the construction of the Channel Tunnel. The year is 1991 and we'll be driving from Hoo Junction as far as Faversham. The class 33 is also known as the Crompton. They were built between 1960 and 1962 and a total of 98 of these locomotives were produced. The total weight of the locomotive is 73 tonnes. And the power output is 1,550 horsepower, giving a maximum tractive effort of 45,000 pounds. The top speed of this locomotive is 85 miles per hour, though the maximum permitted speed on this journey today will be 60 miles per hour. Due to the wagons being unfitted, this means that they themselves have no brakes, so the only brakes on this train will be on the two locomotives at the front, meaning that we have to brake much earlier than usual. As you can see, the cab of the Class 33 looks rather old, and we have a number of different controls which all look very mechanical. The wheel in the middle there is actually the handbrake. And now if we go across to the driver's side, we have the locomotive brake handle, which you can see moving on the far left. We then have the train brake handle, and you can see the brake gauge, which is the second gauge from the left on the dashboard. On this journey we will be using the full service brake setting rather a lot. We have the throttle power handle there, the reversing handle just below that. We also have the speedometer as the second gauge from the right, and finally the gauge on the far right is the ammeter. We have to be careful of that to avoid wheel slip, so we have to watch the amount of amps that we're generating as we increase power. Also on the dashboard here we have three red lights. If the middle light comes on, that means we have wheel slip and I have to reduce power to try and avoid that. Now we need to pull up to the red signal just ahead. And we need to stop there until we're cleared onto the main line. As you can see, the London Charing Cross to Gillingham service has just passed us, so we should be cleared onto the main line shortly.
Mm-hmm.
The speed limit departing Hoo Yard is 15 miles per hour. And once we're on the main line, I won't go faster than about 20 while we're on a single yellow signal. Once on the main line here, the speed limit itself is 70 miles per hour, but as I said earlier, the train cannot go above 60 miles per hour. As you see, we have a single yellow aspect ahead. So I'm going to continue accelerating slightly to a maximum speed of 25 miles per hour. As you can tell, the weight of the train is seriously affecting our acceleration rate, and in addition to that, because the wagons are unfitted, it seriously affects the braking distance. So I will be braking much earlier than usual. Now braking for the red signal you can see just ahead. As that signal has now changed to a yellow aspect, I'll now accelerate back up to 20 miles per hour. As you probably just saw, the signal changed to green just before we passed it, so I will apply a bit more power to accelerate up towards 30 miles per hour. I'm still driving with caution, as I am bearing in mind that we are following another train. Although the signal there displayed a green aspect, I am still going to drive with caution, and the speed limit at the other end of this tunnel at the Strood end drops to 15 miles per hour. So I've got to bear that in mind and ensure that I'm going slow enough to be able to slow down for that speed reduction. As you can see, we're now nearing the end of the tunnel, and we do have a green aspect on the signal. So I'm going to brake lightly in a second, just to ensure that we're slowing down for the 15 mile per hour speed limit about right. As you can see, we have a single yellow aspect at the end of the platform here at Strood, which means that the signal protecting Rochester Bridge Junction is displaying a red aspect. The curve up to Rochester Bridge Junction has a 1 in 40 upward gradient on it, so I'm going to try and slow down so that we're going slow enough that the signal will hopefully change by the time we get to it. Because if we stop on a gradient that steep, starting again will be incredibly challenging. can now see the red signal just coming up around the curve, and it's just changed to a single yellow, which is good timing. So now we don't actually have to stop on this curve. As you can see, this train is seriously struggling on this hill in the power setting I have. We're just about maintaining 5 miles per hour. Thankfully, the hill ends shortly once we've crossed the junction. As you can see, the train is finally accelerating. However, I have to bear in mind that we were on a single yellow signal aspect, so I have to drive assuming the next signal is a red until I can see otherwise. You can now see that the next signal is displaying a double yellow aspect. Therefore, I'm going to apply power and accelerate up to around 20 miles per hour. I do have to take into account the signals along here are very close together, so we do need ample braking distance, which is why I'm driving at such a slow speed. we have a green signal. I'm going to power up towards the 30 mile per hour speed limit. Was just applying the brakes due to the yellow aspect of the signal, but now it's changed to green. I'll accelerate again back up to 30 miles per hour. Speed limit has now gone up to 50, but I'm still going to be driving with caution, knowing that I've just been receiving cautionary aspects. As we have a single yellow signal, I'm slowing down again to 20 miles per hour until I can see what aspect the next signal is displaying. Now see the yellow aspect of the signal ahead, so I've just applied power just to take us up again towards 20 to 25 miles per hour. we now have a green signal aspect. I will throttle up. And the speed limit is 60 miles per hour now, and in fact there will be no changes in the line speed limit, which will affect us all the way to Faversham. Although this signal is showing a green aspect, you can see that the signal beyond that is showing a yellow aspect. And as I'm now doing nearly 50 miles per hour, that means I need to brake as soon as I can see that yellow to ensure that I can slow down in time for the red. We're now in a full service brake application. See just how slow that speedometer needle is going down. As you can see, this is an example of one of the bugs that sometimes happens in railworks, where signals are red when they shouldn't be. So I've just been told I can treat this as a green aspect after requesting permission to pass, which I have. So permission has been approved, and I can now accelerate back up to the maximum speed limit of this service, 60 miles per hour. have a four-track section for a couple of miles until we pass Newington Station. See, we now have a single yellow signal, so I've gone straight into a full service brake application to slow the train down for the red coming up. As you can see, we have a yellow aspect signal ahead, so I'm going to accelerate up to 25 miles per hour till I can see whether this is a single or a double yellow signal. As we now have a green, we can once again accelerate up towards the maximum speed limit. double yellow. I've just shut off power and I'll allow the train to coast towards the next signal. The AWS warning we just received was for a Morpeth board for a left-hand turn onto the Sheerness branch. Therefore, we can ignore it. As you can see, the signal has now changed to green, so once again I'm going to apply power as we head towards Sittingbourne. The line turning off to the left is the Sheerness branch. Now the line joining us from the left is from the Sheerness branch. Now braking, as you can see, the signal ahead is not showing a green aspect, but is showing a double yellow. And as we were doing nearly 60 miles per hour, I needed to make sure that we have enough braking distance. We're still on a double yellow aspect. I've released the brakes at 40 miles per hour, and I'll allow the train to continue to coast at around this speed. Now we have a green aspect, I'm once again applying power to accelerate. Now, as we're on this straight with the houses on the left, we know that we are approaching Faversham. We also have a single yellow signal aspect, so we have to drive carefully. I believe that we're now cleared into the platform at Faversham itself. We're going to be going into Faversham Platform 3, if I remember correctly, which means there's actually no more speed reductions entering Faversham. The speed limit here is 60 miles per hour. Though obviously I couldn't enter anywhere near that quick, or we'd never stop. I'm aiming to enter the platform here at no faster than about 15 miles per hour. You can see our speed is coming off nicely now. We're doing about 17, 16, and now we're doing 15 miles per hour. So you can see the guy on the platform there looks like our replacement driver, and he'll be taking over the train for the rest of the journey to Dover. Thanks for watching this video, and I hope you've enjoyed it.